Hello there, you're watching the Breakfast News on Rajya Sabha Television, your one-stop morning show to keep you updated on the very latest from India and across the world and also giving you an insight on what to expect in the day ahead. Let us start with this morning's headlines. Last day for filing nomination for vice presidential election. M. Venkaiya Naidu and Gopal Krishna Gandhi to file papers, voting on 5th of August. Close to 99% voting in presidential poll conducted on Monday. Winner among Ram Nath Kovind and Meera Kumar to be known on 20th of July. Centre tells the Supreme Court it won't grant a grace period for depositing scrapped 500,000 rupee notes. Says objective of eliminating black money will be defeated. Supreme Court asks Centre to take considered view before taking policy decision on a commercial release of GM mustard. Centre says it is considering various aspects. And three militants killed in encounter in South Kashmir's Anantnag. Encounter broke out during anti-militancy operation in that area. Top story this morning. Today is the last day for filing of nominations for the vice presidential elections. NDA's vice presidential nominee Venkaiya Naidu will file his nomination papers at 11 a.m. in Parliament House. The BJP's parliamentary board had decided on his name as NDA's vice presidential nominee on Monday. The opposition nominee Gopal Krishna Gandhi will also file his nomination papers today. He will file his papers in the presence of top Congress leaders, including Sonia Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi, whose candidature was endorsed by 18 non-NDA parties, including the JDU, will also be accompanied by top opposition leaders, including those from the left parties and the TMC. The scrutiny of the nominations will take place on 19th of July. Voting takes place on 5th of August and counting of votes will also be held on the same day after voting. The BJP on Monday announced Union Minister M. Venkaiya Naidu as its vice presidential nominee for the election that will be held on 5th of August. Now, Naidu, who served as a minister in the Atal Bihari Vajpayee government and enjoys a clear lead in the contest, will be the second BJP leader after Bhairav Singh Shekhawat to occupy the post of the vice president. Naidu became the BJP's president in 2003 at an early age of 54. He has also been associated with the RSS student wing in his early days and was also the president of Andhra University Students Union. He was elected to the Legislative Assembly of Andhra Pradesh twice, in 1978 and again in 1983.
Sri M. Venkaiya Naidu ji, NDA ki aur se uprashtrapati pad ke liye pratyashi honge.
BJP President Amit Shah announcing M. Venkaiya Naidu as the party's vice presidential candidate after a meeting of the BJP parliamentary board.
Parliamentary board ke sabhi sadasya aur NDA ke sabhi sathiyon se charcha karne ke baad parliamentary board in nirnay par pahuncha hai ki bhajpa ke varishth neta aur urban development minister श्री एम वेंकैया नायडू जी एनडीए की ओर से उपराष्ट्रपति पद के लिए प्रत्याशी होंगे।
वेंकैया नायडू विल फेस ऑपोजिशन नॉमिनी गोपाल कृष्ण गांधी इन द वाइस प्रेसिडेंशियल इलेक्शन ऑन 5th अगस्त दैट विल बी डिसाइडेड बाय 790 पार्लियामेंटेरियंस। नायडू हैज अ क्लियर लीड इन द इलेक्टोरल कॉन्टेस्ट विद द बीजेपी लेड नेशनल डेमोक्रेटिक अलायंस हैविंग अ कंबाइंड स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ 410 एमपीज इन बोथ हाउसेस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट।
तो लंबा संसदीय ज्ञान का भंडार उनके पास है, एक समर्पित और निष्ठावान कार्यकर्ता, कुशल संगठक, मौलिक विचारक, प्रशासनिक क्षमता के धनी और संसदीय ज्ञान के उनसे जानकार बहुत कम होते हैं।
प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी हेल्ड नायडू एज अ फिटिंग कैंडिडेट फॉर द ऑफिस ऑफ वाइस प्रेसिडेंट। इन अ सीरीज ऑफ ट्वीट्स ही सेड नायडू'स एक्सपीरियंस विल हेल्प हिम डिस्चार्ज द इंपॉर्टेंट रोल ऑफ राज्यसभा चेयरपर्सन। According to reports, Prime Minister Narendra Modi called up chief ministers of Tamil Nadu, Bihar and Andhra Pradesh and senior leaders including Sharad Pawar seeking their support for Naidu's candidature. Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister N. Chandrababu Naidu hailed the choice of Venkaiah Naidu as candidate for the vice presidential election. YSR Congress too has extended support to Naidu. The rebel AIADMK faction led by former Chief Minister O. Panneerselvam also backed Naidu. Venkaiah Naidu, who hails from Andhra Pradesh, is a prominent face of the BJP from South India. Soon after his nomination, he resigned from the Union Cabinet. He was holding two portfolios of Information and Broadcasting and Housing and Urban Affairs. Two sets of nomination papers in support of Naidu's candidature will be filed today, the last day of nomination. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Home Minister Rajnath Singh, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley and External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj are expected to propose Naidu's name for the top post. Naidu is a four-term member of the Rajya Sabha. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And now let's take a look at all the other reactions on the announcement of Naidu as NDA's vice presidential candidate.
I would like to thank Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji, Amit Shah ji and all the leaders of NDA for choosing a person who has absolute versatile personality, a very rich experience in parliamentary history, parliamentary proceedings, and a person who has successfully led the Rural Development Department and the Urban Development Department.
मैं कह सकता हूँ आज चाहे देश के प्रधानमंत्री हों, चाहे देश के राष्ट्रपति हों, चाहे देश के उपराष्ट्रपति के लिए जिनको आज एनडीए ने अपना प्रत्याशी बनाया है, आज ऐसा लगता है कि दीनदयाल जी ने जो सपना देखा कि उनके हाथ में देश की सत्ता जाए, आज वो सपना साकार हो रहा है।
ये बहुत बड़ी ऐतिहासिक निर्णय है, इसलिए उपराष्ट्रपति राज्यसभा को चलाना और देश की प्रतिष्ठा को मान्यता को बढ़ाना, इसमें वेंकैया नायडू जी इसमें अच्छे जो है इस पद को निर्वहन करने में उनको सारे अनुभव है और हमारे लिए खास करके तेलुगु जनता के लिए ये बहुत बड़ी गर्व की बात है। ये पहली बार एक तेलुगु का व्यक्ति जो है आज उपराष्ट्रपति बनना, और मुझे विश्वास है सारे हमारे दक्षिण राज्यों के जितने भी राजनीतिक पार्टियां हैं वो भी इनको समर्थन करें।
मैं मानता हूं कि उपराष्ट्रपति जैसे गरिमामय पद के लिए जैसे उपयुक्त व्यक्ति की तलाश थी, वैसा उपयुक्त व्यक्ति श्री वेंकैया नायडू जी के रूप में प्राप्त हुआ है हम लोगों को। यहाँ पर राजनीतिक क्षेत्र का उनका एक अनुभव है, एक काम करने की कुशलता है, सांगठनिक कुशलता भी उनके अंदर देखी है, क्योंकि पार्टी अध्यक्ष के रूप में भी उन्होंने जिम्मेदारी निभाई है। कुछ ऐसे जो वैल्यूज होती हैं, जो जीवन मूल्य होते हैं, उन जीवन मूल्यों के प्रति वेंकैया जी की प्रतिबद्धता रही है।
एक कर्मठ कार्यकर्ता जिन्होंने जीवन भर देश को समर्पित किया, जीवन भर समाज सेवा में लगे रहे, पार्टी को बढ़ाने में उनका बहुत बड़ा योगदान रहा। लगभग आज 40 वर्षों से वो समाज सेवा में, देश सेवा में, पहले विद्यार्थी परिषद के कार्यकर्ता, संघ के कर्मठ स्वयंसेवक, किसान का बेटा इस देश का उपराष्ट्रपति बन सकता है, ये अपने आप में एक बहुत बड़ी बात है, हम सबके लिए बहुत खुशी की बात है।
कि वेंकैया नायडू से बेहतर च्वाइस कोई हो नहीं सकता है, उससे अच्छे उपराष्ट्रपति के लिए कोई उम्मीदवार हो नहीं सकते हैं। और मैं प्रधानमंत्री जी को बहुत अपने तरफ से, लोक जनशक्ति पार्टी की तरफ से कोटि कोटि जो है उनको धन्यवाद देता हूं। वेंकैया नायडू जी वरिष्ठतम नेता में से हैं और अक्रॉस द पार्टी, पार्टी से हटकर भी उनके जो क्या कहते हैं सब लोगों से उन जो है सब लोग उनके चाहने वाले हैं।
हिम बीइंग वेंकैया नायडू जी बीइंग वेरी सीनियर पार्लियामेंटेरियन एंड दैट टू अ फेलो तेलुगु मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट, आवर पार्टी टीआरएस हैज डिसाइडेड टू support his candidature and I am confident and very sure with all his experience he'll make a very good vice presidential candidate for this country.
And close to 99% voting was recorded on Monday for electing India's next president, perhaps the highest ever percentage. Now NDA's nominee Ramnath Kovind is in straight fight with opposition's Meera Kumar in what is being called a Dalit versus Dalit contest. The results will be announced on 20th of July. Paper ballots were used in the presidential elections and special arrangements were made at the Parliament House as well as state assemblies for the polling yesterday.
Voting to elect the next president of India ended at 5 p.m. on Monday, with MPs and MLAs casting their ballots in their respective state assemblies. NDA nominee Ram Nath Kovind is pitted against opposition candidate Meera Kumar for the post. Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Amit Shah were among the first to cast their votes in Parliament. Congress President Sonia Gandhi, Vice President Rahul Gandhi and party's Chief Whip in Lok Sabha, Jyotiraditya Sindhya also cast their votes. While NDA candidate Ram Nath Kovind is expected to win with a comfortable margin, the opposition said its joint pick Meera Kumar was the best choice.
मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि आत्मा की आवाज सुनी जाएगी क्योंकि इससे पवित्र और इससे शक्तिशाली और कुछ नहीं है और देश के हित में देश के भविष्य के लिए निर्णय लिया जाएगा।
I am sure Ramnath Kovind ji will win with a comfortable, respectable margin.
It is between two ideologies. So the president of India is occupying such a position who has to safeguard the interest of the entire nation.
सब MPs के ऊपर और सब MLAs के ऊपर अपनी अंतरात्मा के आधार पर अपनी कॉन्शियंस के आधार पर वोट डालें।
While the Trinamool Congress is backing Meera Kumar, its Tripura unit however decided to back Ram Nath Kovind. With both Kovind and Kumar belonging to the Dalit community, BSP Chief Mayawati expressed satisfaction that a Dalit leader would occupy the highest office.
ये हर एक अलग चीज है, लेकिन अच्छी बात यह है कि दोनों में से कोई भी जीते, लेकिन खुशी की बात यह है कि सुल कास्ट का आदमी तो देश का राष्ट्रपति बनेगा।
हमारी आशा यही रहेगी कि अच्छे व्यक्ति जो इस पद की गरिमा को रख सकते हैं, संविधान की रक्षा कर सकते हैं, वो जीते। और इसमें कोई, अब क्योंकि राष्ट्रपति का चुनाव है, अब अन्य कोई राजनीति वोटिंग के बाद न देखी जाए।
In Bihar, Chief Minister Nitish Kumar, led JDU, is supporting NDA candidate Ram Nath Kovind, while senior partner of the Grand Alliance, RJD, is backing opposition candidate Meera Kumar. After casting his vote, Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath said he was confident of Kovind winning by a huge margin.
NDA ke pratyashi se Ramnath Kovind ji bhari bahumat se chunav jeetenge, isme koi sandeh nahi hai. Uttar Pradesh ka ye saubhagya hai ki pehli baar Uttar Pradesh ko rashtrapati dene ka avsar prapt ho raha hai.
Hamari party ne Ramnath Kovind ka samarthan kiya hai aur hum वो आज विजयी होंगे, ऐसा हम मान के चलते।
Counting of the votes will be on Thursday. The term of President Pranab Mukherjee ends on the 24th of this month. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And the 243rd session of the Rajya Sabha commenced on Monday. The upper house, however, was adjourned for the day as a mark of respect to departed sitting members Anil Madhav Dave and Palvai Govardhan Reddy.
Honourable members, I refer with profound sorrow to the passing away.
Rajya Sabha condoled the death of former Union Environment Minister Anil Madhav Dave. Chairman Mohammad Hamid Ansari noted that Dave was a social worker who strove for conservation of the Narmada River. He represented Madhya Pradesh in the upper house for 3 terms, from August 2009 to January 2010. June 2010 to June 2016 and from June 2016 till his demise.
A social worker, Shri Dave worked assiduously for the conservation of River Narmada and its catchment area through Narmada Samagra, an organization founded by him for the conservation of rivers and for addressing climate change and environmental issues.
The House also bemoaned the demise of veteran Congress leader Palvai Govardhan Reddy, who represented Andhra Pradesh in Rajya Sabha from April 2012 to June 2014 and Telangana from June 2014 till his demise.
In the passing away of Shri Palvai Govardhan Reddy, the country has lost a distinguished parliamentarian and a dedicated social worker.
Environment Minister Anil Dave passed away on May 18th at the age of 60. Dave had been unwell since suffering from pneumonia. While Palvai Govardhan Reddy died of a heart attack in Kullu in Himachal Pradesh on June 9th. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
An earlier Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed the media ahead of the monsoon session of Parliament. He hoped that political parties would engage in high standards of debate and provide value addition during the session.
Before the monsoon session began, Prime Minister Narendra Modi thanked all parties for their support in rolling out GST. He said that he hoped that the growing stronger together spirit of GST would bring enthusiasm to Parliament proceedings. The Prime Minister also said that the passage of GST showed that good can be achieved when all parties come together and work for the nation.
Growing stronger together. ये जीएसटी स्पिरिट का दूसरा नाम है। ये सत्र भी उस जीएसटी स्पिरिट के साथ आगे बढ़े। इस सत्र अनेक रूप से महत्वपूर्ण है कि सभी राजनीतिक दल, सभी माननीय सांसदगण राष्ट्रहित के महत्वपूर्ण फैसले लेकर के उत्तम स्तर की चर्चा करके हर विचार में वैल्यू एडिशन करने का प्रयास, हर व्यवस्था में वैल्यू एडिशन का प्रयास हम सब मिलकर के करेंगे, ऐसा मेरा पूरा विश्वास है।
The Prime Minister also called the monsoon session a very significant one as the country will celebrate 70 years of independence during this time and also elect a new president and vice president.
15 अगस्त को आजादी के 7 दशक की यात्रा हम पूर्ण कर रहे हैं। 9 अगस्त को सत्र के दरमियान ही अगस्त क्रांति के 75 साल हो रहे हैं। एक प्रकार से राष्ट्र जीवन के अत्यंत महत्वपूर्ण घटनाओं से भरा हुआ ये कालखंड है और इसलिए स्वाभाविक है कि देशवासियों का ध्यान हमेशा की तरह इस मॉनसून सत्र पर विशेष रहेगा।
The session, which began on Monday, will conclude on August 11th after 20 sittings. However, the government won't have it easy, with the opposition expected to corner it on issues including the Dokola standoff in Sikkim with China, violence in Darjeeling, situation in Jammu and Kashmir, demonetization and GST. Pancharan Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And in breakfast news, time for a very short break. We'll be right back with more news. Stay tuned.
आजादी की जंग लड़ने वाले मेरे दोस्तों, आजादी चाहिए तो उसकी कीमत खून देके चुकानी होगी। तुम मुझे खून दो, मैं तुम्हें आजादी दूंगा।
आईएनए के बागी फौजियों पर अंग्रेज देशद्रोह का मुकदमा चलाएंगे।
उन तीनों के बचने के चांसेस कम हैं।
Judgment will be remembered throughout history.
Thanks for staying with us. The center has told the Supreme Court that no more grace period will be granted for depositing the scrapped 500,000 rupee notes. The center informed the Apex Court that the very objective of a demonetization and the elimination of black money will be defeated if a fresh window is given. The center was responding to the 4th of July directive by the court asking it to consider granting a window to those who have not been able to exchange the scrap notes for genuine reasons. The Apex Court had said that the people should not lose their own money for no fault of theirs. The government affidavit said that none of the petitioners have given any valid grounds as to why they could not deposit the scrap notes through his or her authorized third person. The government also said that sufficient time has been given to people to exchange notes and deposit it. And the Supreme Court has asked the centre to take a considered and well-informed view before taking a policy decision on the commercial release of a genetically modified mustard crop or the GM mustard crop. The apex court has said that the effects of such a move would be irreversible. The court also granted a week's time to the centre to apprise it of the situation as to when will it take a policy decision on the rollout. The centre has said that it has not taken any policy decision on the commercial release of GM mustard crop and was considering various aspects. It has also invited suggestions and objections on the issue. The apex court had in October last year extended the stay on commercial release of the GM mustard crop till further orders. It had asked the government to seek public opinion on such issues before releasing it for cultivation purposes. Now, mustard is one of India's most important winter crops, which is sown between mid-October and late November. On to some other news, the GST Council on Monday hiked the cess on cigarettes to take away the windfall manufacturers were getting due to an anomaly in it after the GST rate fixation. The council took the decision after receiving the compensation cess rates on cigarettes in its meeting in New Delhi. The new rate came into effect from midnight. Now, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley said that a cess on cigarettes of up to 6 millimetres in size was raised by 485 rupees per 1,000 sticks and on those exceeding 65 millimetres by 792 rupees per 1,000 sticks. The charge on cess would fetch 5,000 crore rupees additional revenue for the government. However, consumer prices will not change as the increased tax incidence would only take away the windfall profits that the manufacturers were earning. Now, Jaitley also said that the next meeting of the council will take place in the first week of next month to review the progress of the new indirect tax regime, GST.
So the rate of 28% remains. On ad valorem, on the compensation cess, the 5% ad valorem remains. But the numerical amount for each category has been increased by amounts like rupees 485 per thousand, rupees 620 per thousand, and rupees 792 per thousand.
And on to the other top story of the day, a 5-judge constitution bench of the Supreme Court would commence today the hearing on a batch of petitions challenging the validity of the Aadhaar scheme and the aspect of right to privacy attached to it. The constitution bench would comprise the Chief Justice J.S. Keher and Justices J. Chelmeshwara, S.A. Bobde, D.Y. Chandrachur and S. Abdul Nazir. The apex court had agreed to set up a bench on 12th of July to deal with the Aadhaar-related matters after Attorney General K.K. Venugopal and Senior Advocate Shyam Diwan appearing for petitioners who have challenged the government's move to make Aadhaar mandatory for various public welfare schemes had jointly mentioned the matters. The 3-judge bench had in 2015 referred to the Constitution bench the batch of petitions challenging the Aadhaar card scheme to decide whether right to privacy was a fundamental right. And government's panel on Air India's divestment will hold its first official meeting today to discuss the modalities of privatizing India's national carrier. The ministerial panel, headed by Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, will take a call on various options to deal with Air India's debt burden of over 52,000 crore rupees. Union Ministers Ashok Gajapati Raju and Nitin Gadkari are the other members of the panel. The Union Cabinet had given in its principal approval for the Air India's divestment after Niti Aayog recommended strategic disinvestments in the loss-making airline. Now, Foreign Secretary S. Jaishankar will brief a parliamentary committee today on the issue of the China-India standoff. The panel includes Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi and is headed by Congress MP Shashi Tharoor. Now, China and India are engaged in a standoff in Sikkim's Dokhla area near the Bhutan Tri-Junction for over 3 weeks now after a Chinese army's construction team attempted to build a road there. Last week, a meeting was also called by the government to brief the opposition on the issue. On to developments from Jammu and Kashmir, and an army jawan was martyred, a girl was killed, while four persons were injured in heavy firing and mortar shelling by the Pakistan army along the line of control in Poonch area, as well as the Rajouri and Baramulla districts on Monday. Pakistani army resorted to unprovoked mortar shelling and firing. The Indian army retaliated, triggering heavy exchanges. Pakistan also shelled mortars on civilian areas in Balakot and Manjakot and Borti belts. Meanwhile, the bodies of the three terrorists who were killed in an encounter in Anantnag were recovered and identified. The encounter broke out at around 8 p.m. on Monday in Wanihama village of Anantnag, following an anti-militancy operation launched by the security forces. Now, one AK-47, one SLR and one pistol has also been seized. Now, all schools in the border of Manjakot and Balakot areas are closed, and people have been advised not to come out of their homes in view of the heavy shelling. Later in the day, Pakistani troops reportedly started unprovoked firing at three villages in Kamalkot area of Uri in Baramulla district at around 3 p.m. One soldier was injured in the firing. And flood fury in several states across the country continues. Another death toll in Assam flood rose to 65. The overall situation improved marginally. Around 8 lakh people affected across 17 districts in the state. And Chief Minister Sarbanand Sonowal has directed the district officials to ensure that families affected by the floods were provided with relief material. Meanwhile, in Gujarat, at least 11 people have been killed by heavy rains. Several low-lying areas in Western Kutch district have been submerged, creating problems for the residents there. While in Telangana, heavy rains triggered flash floods, throwing normal life out of gear. The Nagavali River is flowing above the danger mark. The Met Department has predicted if more rain fall in the next 24 hours. Meanwhile, in Odisha, the flood situation in Raigarh and Kalahandi areas has improved. Several teams of the NDRF, ODRF, fire services and police personnel are carrying out relief and rescue operations. Around 40,000 people have been affected across 80 villages in the state. The Chief Minister of the state, Naveen Patnaik, has taken stock of the situation.
Telangana state is also likely to receive light to moderate rainfalls in many of the places, with one or two spells of heavy to very heavy rainfalls during next 3 days. And as it moves northwestward direction, the rainfall is likely to decrease from fourth day onwards.
The flood situation in Kalahandi and Raigarh districts is improving. Free kitchens have been opened for affected people in those areas, as well as in Cuttack city. Airdropping of relief materials has been done in Raigarh district.
And with this, it is a wrap on this edition of News. But news and updates continue on your channel. Thanks so much for watching.